Uncertainty and turmoil are increasing after yesterday's shock proposal to axe news production and hundreds of jobs at TV3. There's also unease over what it might mean for other well-known Kiwi programs and our next generation of broadcasters. Kim Baker-Wilson has today's developments.
It's the day after for Newshub's viewers and its staff.
You've likely seen the news by now that our company has proposed to shut down Newshub from June. Some people have been asking, does that affect AM too? And AM and Newshub are one and the same. We're all part of the same family.
A family where about 300 jobs are set to go.
Thank you.
Sparking fears from those at the start of their careers.
See what happens and pray for the best.
Fears over upheaval beyond the newsroom.
It was a shock. And a really dark day for New Zealand broadcasting.
And fears for the entire sector.
I was expecting cutbacks, not a complete demolition.
What's set to be taken off the air, leaving the much wider sector up in the air.
The likes of The Block and The Traitors and Married at First Sight New Zealand, they're all at risk and at jeopardy because basically you have to go to the funding agencies now to bring in the money. They can't pay for them.
Part of the problem, he says, out-of-date legislation.
The time is up now for the government to stop kicking the can down the road and actually start making some decisions about the future of the production industry and the media industry in New Zealand because we're out of time.
New Zealand On Air says it started fresh talks with Warner Brothers Discovery. There's $30 million set aside for content yet to make it on screen. TV3 had humble beginnings. Several decades of news making.
This is 3 News.
And news breaking. One of its longest serving reporters not expecting the complete cull.
Probably cut back on the news, like maybe turn it into a half hour show, maybe drop it at the weekends.
He teaches the up and comers of a fragile career.
There are fewer jobs. However, sometimes with this sort of thing, opportunities can arise.
Exactly what his students are hoping for.
It's kind of gutting to hear that news on an industry you kind of want to go into.
It creates a really scary scenario for us new ones.
And ripping out such a huge part of it gets a bit nerve-wracking.
It's scary, but I'm staying optimistic for sure.
That's what Newshub staff are having to be as well.
It's been pretty tough, but we'll get through it.
Through until June, when the studio lights are switched off. Kim Baker-Wilson, One News.
Meanwhile, Media and Communications Minister Melissa Lee says she's taking the axing of Newshub seriously and admits she should have been more articulate when talking about it yesterday. Labor's criticised the minister's initial comments, including her pointing to Sky News as an alternative news outlet. She was asked about that comment in Parliament.
Is she aware of who produces Sky News or Sky News's New Zealand content?
Yeah.
Sky News that I was referring to actually is produced by Newshub.
Melissa Lee says while Newshub's closure will have flow-on effects for the local production industry, it's not the government's job to provide relief. And it's not just New Zealand. Warner Brothers Discovery is facing rocky times globally. For a bit of context, the media giant stable includes Warner Movies, think smash hit Barbie and current underperforming Aquaman, news channel CNN, pay TV network HBO, streaming service Max, the Food Network, HGTV, Discovery Channel, Animal Planet, and many, many more. Reports show the company's currently worth about $113 billion, including net debt of $70 billion. But it's tough. Warner Brothers Discovery's shares in the US have plunged 47% in the past year, just a few days ago, nearing a 52-week low. And it came after its quarterly earnings out last week showed weak linear TV advertising and underachieving movies. The company's chief executive saying these are challenging times for the multinational with a presence in most countries around the world.